Listen, I mean, the whole Dubai saga proved that quarantine actually helped the country in a big way. So most of the capital, you know, that usually is deployed in either stock market or into different products have seen a large, uprise all over the world. So real estate globally has seen, during the quarantine, has been seen as a very attractive asset class for a lot of investors globally. And Dubai came at the forefront of that, mainly due to having the country open, being able to manage the crisis in a smart way, make sure the testing occurs on very high numbers. So I believe that, you know, the investment world actually was, I mean, COVID was very good for the investment world, to be honest with you, especially on the real estate. So as much as people thought it was going to have a negative effect, it actually had a very positive effect. And to elaborate more on this, I would say that many people who live in apartments or live in Europe in the, you know, in the cold weathers in the winter, they came out here and, you know, you've seen what happened from the villa perspective. I mean, villa sales have gone up maybe 5 times versus last year. So that's a very, very attractive number. You don't see that anywhere else in the world. The revenues of all the companies have gone up by at least 4 to 5 times in terms of real estate business. And this is not by coincidence. This is the quarantining, you know. So exactly, it's COVID. It's the whole issue that happened globally. And it was actually a very positive effect to that point. For us, it's very clear. We focus on the super high net worth individuals. We cater for the 1%. And this is our business model as a global company. As you know, Vanessa, we've done over $150 billion of sales globally as a company versus 120 last year in 2019. So our figures increased by at least 15% globally. That's a very high number when the country, when the world is closed down. So what makes our business model is that we're focused. We deal with high net worth. We are actually the private banking model when it comes to the real estate. When people think about brands, when they're buying their clothes, they go to Hermès, they go to Louis Vuitton. When they think about cars, they think about the, you know, the Ferraris, the Range Rovers, the top brand. And when they think about real estates, of course, Sotheby's is one of the top three names that comes across everybody's mind. It shows the, you know, the integrity, the transparency, and most importantly, is the trust that they give into the brand. The brand is 300 years old. It has its global status, and so our business model is based around the key factors that is our brand mainly. And, you know, we've had it really successful over the last probably few years now. To keep going at it, you know, like we think that the market here, you know, is noticed a major shift of end user buyers. We want to keep that focus. But again, we're aligning ourselves with the development and developers that suit our brand. As you know, we were selling the Four Seasons residence on the Canal. We've sold out this product totally. We only have 3 units left in a matter of 3 months. And now we have 3 more projects coming to life, which I cannot disclose today. But again, they're of the level of Four Seasons. So we, as a company, we're going to keep going on with this same business model for the next 6 to 12 months, and I think a bit more. I think, you know, when you surround yourself with people better than you, that's key. You know, so I've done 21 years on the banking side. So my success was relationship, trustworthiness with people, speaking your mind, doing the extra mile, getting the trust of people. Because again, when you're buying real estate, it's like opening a bank account with people. So you're not gonna open a bank account with somebody over the internet or over WhatsApp chat. You need to meet them, you need to have the confidence, the trust to buy, especially when we're selling 20 million dirham homes and above. They need to know who is the person they're buying from. They need to feel that he's talking the right language, you know, the right, representing the property in the right way. So I think, you know, this is who we are as people, and this is the way I've always been successful in my business as an individual. You know, I've spent 20 years on the banking, of which probably 15 years in Dubai before I opened up Sotheby's. And I've been here 22 years. So being here 22 years, for sure, you must, you know, as an entrepreneur being totally based on sales, you need to know how to, you know, to do your business. And again, the main factors is trust, as I said, doing the extra mile and showing your clients you know what you're talking about. It's very important. That's actually a very important point. In our company, we as owners do not broker. You know, myself and my partner, Chris, we do not do any deal in the company. So all the deals we have, they go into our team. So the team are very comfortable dealing with owners that are not competing with them. The last thing you want is do exactly what you hire people to do. Eventually, they're going to feel that you're taking the best clients over from them. You're taking, you know, the lion's share. In our case, our team are driven by that, one. Two, when there is a problem, we beat them very hard. So we're hard on them. And the reason why we're hard on them, because we want them to get better. So some people tell me, you either survive George or he cracks you up, you know, so you're either going to survive him or you're going to leave. So today the team, you know, that we have, I would say probably a good 80% of it have been with the company for over 2 to 3 years. They know how we work. They know that we have a room for error, but at the same time, we're very focused. We know what they're doing. We know the mistakes that sometimes take place. We always try to improve. And I believe this is a drive to them because they see us. We're always first in the morning and we're always last out. So we're never coming in late. We're never taking the days off as we should. So we have more heart in the business. And I think most of our team, mainly on the support side, you know, they behave like owners. They have the, you know, the commitment to the company. And I think that starts from me because I show them how much I commit, even though I've been very successful on the banking. So, you know, I've made my money in my life. So being now doing the extra mile in a different industry shows them that, you know, they believe in that. And I think this is mainly, you know, how we trickle all the way down.